After over a year of living with family in the States, my usually Whole Foods plant-based kids have gotten really used to American snacks. So today I'm making four healthier alternatives to some of their favorite processed snacks, including Clif bars, Fig Newtons, salty crackers, and even candy bars. I've linked all of these recipes in the description box below, and I've even created a free PDF so you can download all of the recipes in one place. Okay, let's jump into the first recipe, Clif bars. To start, we are going to place some chewy, sticky medjool dates, if possible, into a food processor and process those until they're nice and broken down and sticky. I love using dates in granola bars because they add a lot of natural sweetness and help hold your granola bars together. Next to these chopped up dates, we are going to add some puffed cereal, if possible, some rolled oats, and chopped nuts, which my daughter loved to nibble on. Then we're going to add in some ground flaxseed, cinnamon, and a pinch of salt. You're going to process that again until all nice and broken down and combined before pouring it into a bowl and adding in some warmed up maple syrup and peanut butter. This recipe is super adaptable. I didn't have puffed cereal, so I used Cheerios. I didn't have almond butter, so I used peanut butter. You really can use whatever you want. Once you get a sticky dough, you're gonna press this into a parchment paper lined baking sheet until nice and firm. I love to use the bottom of a cup to do this as well. And then all you have to do is place these in the fridge to chill. Once they've chilled, just remove them from the pan and cut them into whatever size you want. If you want them to be more like Clif bars, then you can leave them in 8 rectangles, but I cut them a little bit smaller for my kids into 16 bars. The whole family loves these, and I know you guys will too. As a kid, I did not like Fig Newtons, but my kids love them. My dad loves them, and so they have gotten really used to some store-bought Fig Newtons, so I thought I would make an old but delicious recipe on my blog for homemade Fig Newtons. To start, you're gonna make a pretty wet dough by whisking together all your wet ingredients, and then adding in your whole wheat flour and cinnamon and salt until you get this nice, wet, sticky dough. I love to chill this in the fridge in some plastic wrap if possible, or even stick it in the freezer just for about 20 minutes to firm up. And then you're going to take half of your dough, roll it out into as neat of a rectangle as possible. And then you're gonna take some dried figs, process them into a paste. I didn't even have figs, so I just used a mixture of dates and prunes, and this was so amazing. But you're gonna spread that paste down the middle of your rectangle, fold the sides up, just press together any parts that broke. It's really not a big deal. Cut them into Newton shapes, spread them out, and bake them in the oven. I don't like store-bought Fig Newtons, but I absolutely love these. The bottom is a little bit crispy, the inside is chewy, and they are so good. Next up, we are making a salty, crunchy snack with some homemade crackers. This would be super intimidating to me back in the day, but now I know crackers are so easy to make. You just whisk together your whole wheat flour, spices, seeds if you have them, add in some olive oil to make them crispy, and water until you get a nice moldable dough. And then you are gonna break this dough in half and work with just half of it at a time. I love these silicone baking mats for a lot of these recipes, and they really come in handy when spreading out your cracker dough as thin as possible, which is what I'm doing here. I just fold over some of the weird bits and just continue to roll it out until it's as thin as possible. Next, you can top it with coarse sea salt, some more poppy seeds or sesame seeds, and then take your rolling pin and gently roll those into the dough so that they don't fall off after baking. Next, you're gonna take a sharp knife and score your dough into whatever shape you want. I usually just do rectangles, but if you wanted to be creative, you could use cookie cutters or whatever. Slide this onto a baking sheet and bake them for about 10 to 15 minutes until nice and crispy. Usually the edges are thinner, and so they will get crispier quickest. So sometimes I will remove the outer crackers and then put the middle crackers into the oven to bake a little bit longer just so that they get crispy as well. Next up, we are making my favorite recipe in this video, which is for homemade Almond Joys or a candy bar alternative. To start, you're gonna put some unsweetened shredded coconut oil, and maple syrup into a food processor and process this until the coconut breaks down and everything kind of becomes sticky and can hold together when you pinch it between your fingers. Then just chill this dough in the fridge for a little while to harden up, and now you are going to create your Almond Joy shaped candy bars. So I just like to press them into small little rectangles and just do this until you finish using up all the dough. And then you are going to press an almond into the center of your rectangles to create your Almond Joy center. If you don't care for nuts or have an allergy, you can always omit this part, but I love the crunch that it adds in the center of this candy bar. Next, take some dairy-free chocolate chips or a chocolate bar, melt that down either in a microwave-safe bowl or in a double boiler, and then you are gonna dip your Almond Joy centers into the melted chocolate. Use a fork to shake off any extra chocolate and continue this process until all of your bars have been coated in your melted dark chocolate, and then just stick these in the fridge or freezer to harden, and then you'll have some delicious, decadent homemade Almond Joys to enjoy throughout the week. And there you have it, four healthy plant-based kid snacks that even adults will love. Again, don't forget to download the free PDF with all of these recipes, which I've linked down below in the description box. And I'll see you guys very soon. Bye!